Foot rot is the most troublesome disease of sheep and goat. It is highly infectious disease and highly contagious disease also. It may affect one or more feet. All age groups are affected, including pre-weaning lambs and kids also. And young ones are more susceptible in fact. And compared to the adults, young ones are more susceptible. And sheep suffer severely than goats. This is a very important point to be noted by the field veterinarians. Foot rot is seen mostly in sheep. It is seen in goat also, but goat suffers very less than compared to sheep. It is a common problem noticed in majority of sheep flocks. And this disease is prevalent. It is always prevalent in 15 to 16% of the sheep and goat flock. It seldom causes deaths. See, whatever the deaths we notice in foot rot, they are due to hypoglycemia only, not because of the disease. The mortality rate is around 3%. The first outbreak is confirmed in Jammu and Kashmir in India. And foot rot is most prevalent in Andhra Pradesh, Telangana, Tamil Nadu and Karnataka. Maybe because of high density of sheep and goat population in these states. See, foot rot is caused by two bacteria, and it is caused by synergistic action of two anaerobic bacteria. See, one should understand about this point. See, for taking up treatment, one should have keep in mind about how to treat anaerobic bacteria. So foot rot is caused by two different bacteria, Physobacterium nephroforum, Dicalobacter nodosus. But it is caused because of synergistic action of these two bacteria. No single bacteria can cause foot rot in the animals. Dicalobacter nodosus was known as Bacteroides nodosus earlier. Now it is called as Dicalobacter nodosus. Let us understand about these two bacteria, these two anaerobic bacteria. F. nephroforum found normally in soil. See, this is very important point to be noted by the field veterinarians. This is found normally in soil and manure of pastures and feedlots. It is a natural inhabitant of large intestines. This is another important point. It is natural inhabitant of large intestine. And physoforum necroforum, it causes foot scab, not foot rot. Foot scab is caused by F. nephroforum. And the Dicalobacter nodosus is present in soil. Like F. nephroforum, this is also present in soil. But there are 8 strains in D. nodosus. There are 8 different strains in D. nodosus. And it is capable of living in the soil for 10 to 14 days only. D. nodosus is capable of living in the soil for 10 to 14 days only. But it can survive in the hoof for 24 days under anaerobic environment. As it is anaerobic bacteria, if anaerobic environment is available in the hoof, it can survive for 24 days. The virulent strains, see there are two types of strains in D. nodosus, virulent strains, they can survive deep unexposed lesions in the foot for many years. So because of this reason only, the prevalence of foot rot is much in sheep flocks continuously. The source of infection is through infected animal. If an ailing animal is present in the flock, it becomes a source of infection. And if there is a carrier animal, it is also a source of infection. These two are the source of infection within the flock. If an infected animal is available in the flock, it becomes a source of infection. And if a carrier animal is there in the flock, it is also a source. See, infected sheep, if it is present in the flock, it spreads the infection to the ground, spreads the infection to the manure, spreads the infection to the bedding, etc., where it is then picked up by the healthy sheep. This is the main reason how a healthy sheep will get infected from the infected sheep. And carriers in the flock will continue to reinfect the flock. Carriers, they continue to reinfect the flock unless the animal is either culled or the organism eliminated by the proper treatment. As long as the carrier is present in the flock, So it becomes a source of infection. Then what are the risk factors? Introduction of an infected VNA. If a farmer owns a flock which is healthy, and if an infected animal is introduced into the flock, it becomes a risk factor. And infected shed floors also risk factors. Wet and moist floors, poor sanitation and biosecurity, damage to the foot integrity. This is very, very important point. If the foot integrity is damaged because of wet conditions, particularly in rainy season and because of wet floors, and if they walk on coarse grass for grazing, and if the pasture where they go for grazing, it is prickly, or if there are injuries due to hoof trimming. So all these are the risk factors for the infection of foot rot. Then what is the precursor? Precursor of foot rot is the foot scab. It is caused by F. necrophorum. It is seen mostly in goats. This is another important point to be noted. In the beginning slides, I told that foot rot is seen mostly in sheep, not in goats. But whereas foot scald is seen mostly in goats. The entry is through interdistal irritation or trauma. And interdistal irritation may be due to accumulation of mud, accumulation of manure due to wet and moist and cold conditions. If there is accumulation of mud in between interdistal space, and if there is accumulation of manure in between interdistal space, there will be interdistal irritation. So if there is irritation, so the organism enters through this irritated area into the body. Another portal of entry is trauma, maybe because of hard frozen ground leading to cracks and lacerations in between the interdistal space, and overgrown hoof, cracked sole. And while doing hoof trimming, so they may suffer with trauma also. And if the goat are walking on coarse grass or on prickly pasture, so there will be trauma. There is every chance of getting trauma in between the interdistal space. So because of this reason, this is seen mostly in goats only. Now let us understand what is foot scab. In foot scab, the bacteria, which is an anaerobic bacteria, infects the soft, irritated interdistal area, causing foot scab. See, this is the soft interdistal area. This is being infected with F. necrophorum bacteria. It does not affect the hard part of the hoof. This is another important point. In foot scald, the hard part is not affected. Only the soft interdistal area only is affected. And this foot scald is restricted to interdistal skin only. It is characterized by reddened inflamed tissue between the toes. Please note this point. See, this part is affected in foot scald, not the hard part. Then what are the symptoms of foot rot? Lameness. Lameness and reluctant to move are the major two symptoms of over foot rot. The animal which is suffering with foot rot, it exhibits pain on walking. And we will notice foal swelling with grey colored fuss also. Affected animal often carry the affected leg or lie down for extended periods. You can see this sheep, it is trying to lift the affected leg, whereas in the below picture, it is lying down. It is not even standing on the affected foot. So the deaths are due to starvation only. This is important point to be noted by the veterinarians while treating the animals. See, deaths are due to starvation because of this pain, because of lameness, and because of reluctance to move for grazing. It may not get sufficient food. So because of malnutrition and insufficient food, it may suffer with hypoglycemia, and hypoglycemia leads to death of the animal. So while treating the animal, you need to provide glucose also. And foot rot is characterized by exudative inflammation. See, there will be a lot of inflammation, and you can find the pus also. Necrosis of epidermis of interdistal skin and hoof also. So there will be necrosis of interdistal skin and necrosis of hoof also. Finally, the hoof is separated from the underlying soft tissue. But whereas this type of condition is not noticed in foot scan, separation of hoof is noticed only in foot rot. And foot rot affects interdistal skin only. You can appreciate by seeing this picture. It affects living tissue of the digits. So you can see the below picture. And the area between toes becomes moist and reddened because of separation from horny tissue. So these two pictures, they clearly indicate how the animal suffers with foot rot. And the tissues which are damaged in foot rot also can be seen by seeing these pictures. And once the animal gets infection, the hoof is separated from the hoof for 10 to 14 days after getting the infection. So minimum 2 weeks period is required for separation of hoof. And after 4 weeks, the horn is completely detached from the foot. The horn is completely detached. So chronic cases appears black and tarry also. You can see this picture. See, this hoof is separated. So you can see black and tarry colored appearance of the hoof. And once it gets infected, so there may be miasis also. Fly strike is a major problem if the case is not attended in time. So there are two types of foot rot. One is virulent form, another is benign form. And these two are caused by different strains of D. nodosus only. Please note this point. Foot rot is caused because of synergistic action of two anaerobic bacteria. One is Physophorum necrophorum, another is Diclobacter nodosus. And there are two different kind of organisms, virulent strains and benign strains in D. nodosus. All the virulent strains are heat stable strains. They causes more severe form. And all benign strains are heat unstable strains. In the beginning slide, I told there are 8 strains in D. nodosus. And among those 8 strains, few are heat stable strains, which causes severe form of foot rot. And fewer heat unstable strains, which causes benign strains, and this causes a milder form. Whereas virulent strains, they cause the severe. So as per the severity or as per the intensification of the infection, given 5 level scoring. One is score 1, score 2, score 3, score 4, score 5. And in score 5, this is the mild inflammation. There will be just a reddening of the skin between the toes. But in score 2, this is little bit intensive form. There will be tissue damage of the soft horn of the inner one. And in score 3, there will be moderate tissue damage. And in score 5, there will be severe tissue damage. Very severe tissue destruction with underrunning, reaching deep layers of the outer wall of the toe is noticed. So score 5 condition is more dangerous and more fatter in case of shoe. So this is the normal hoof, normal foot. In score 1, there will be mild inflammation as shown in the picture. This is score 2, where the inflammation is mild. This is score 3, where the inflammation is moderate. Score 4, here you can find severe damage. The damage reaches out to the outer edge of the sole. Whereas in score 5, there will be severe tissue destruction. So you can see, you can appreciate from seeing this picture. And the infection reaches out the deep layers of the outer wall and the toe also. See, diagnosis is based on the history, and it is based on the symptoms, and it is based on the spread. Whenever a farmer approaches the field veterinarian presenting a foot rot case, we should take the proper history of the flock, since how long the animals are suffering, and if there is any history of cases in other flocks of the same village or not. So it gives a clear idea about the history. And the main symptom in foot rot is the lameness and the foul smelling So these two are the major symptoms of foot rot. The spread pattern, if it is spreading too fast within the flock, we can suspect foot rot, but it can be differentiated with other conditions wherein the lameness is main symptom, but confirmation can be done by gelatin gel test only. How to control foot rot? There are three ways of control. One is preventing the further spread. This is very, very important point. And we have to isolate the affected animal and we have to treat the affected animals. One is preventing further spread. So these are the three means of control we follow in other outbreaks also. So if there is an outbreak of PPR, if there is an outbreak of sheepfox, we follow the same type of control measures. The first thing, we need to prevent further spread within the flock, and we have to isolate the affected animals, and we have to treat the affected, not to become it a source of infection within the flock. Then how to prevent further spread within the flock? See, culling off all those which are not responding for the treatment is very, very important, because an ailing animal is a source of infection for foot rot. So first you try to treat the animal. If it is not responding properly and if it is not fully responded, then better way is to cull it. So this is one way of preventing further spread. Otherwise it becomes a source of infection for the rest of the flock. And always try to keep foot dry. Wet condition is one of the risk factors I have explained in the beginning slides. If the foot is wet, any accumulation of mud or manure in between the interdigital space, it becomes a risk factor. So always try to keep the foot of the animal dry. And still, even if you take all the measures to keep the foot dry, so there may be every chance of getting the floor wet. It may become moist because of rainy season or because of some other season. So always try to spread lime on the floor. This is dry lime powder. So you can spread lime on the floor, especially around the water troughs. See, whenever the sheep goes for drinking water from the water troughs, there is every chance of getting their feet not infected, so they may become wet. So if the foot becomes wet, it may become a source of infection or it may become a risk factor. So in an affected flock, the top 12-inch layer of shed, the top 12-inch layer of shed flooring is to be removed. So D-nodosus is capable of living in the soil for a period of 10 to 14 days. So to eliminate the D-nodosus from the top 12-inch layer of the soil of the shed, we need to remove the top 12-inch layer of the shed flooring, and a new layer of gravel with 6-inch thickness shall be placed after sprinkling dry lime powder. First, you remove 12-inch layer from the shed flooring, then sprinkle the lime powder, then again put a new layer of gravel with 6-inch thickness. So it helps preventing infection. The second way of control is isolation of affected animals. And this is very, very important. Otherwise, the ailing animal is a source of infection. See, the two sources of infection is, one is ailing animal and another is the carrier animal. So ailing animal should not be there in the flock, otherwise it becomes a source of infection. Broad spectrum antibiotics are a choice of the drugs, because the two bacteria which causes foot rot with their synergistic action are anaerobic organisms, and topical applications are to be applied to prevent from miasis, fly spray. So for healthy animals, they can be made to stand in the foot bath for 10 to 15 minutes, but in open grazing system, this is not always practicable. You always try to keep the feet dry. And the night shuttle of the affected should be shifted every day to a new place to prevent further spread of D-nodosus. This is another important point. In the earlier side, I told you to remove the top 12-inch layer of the soil, but wherever there is possibility, wherever there is a chance, always it is better to shift the night shelter every day till the problem is subsided from the flock. Then how to prevent the infection? See, food scald is the precursor. So we need to effectively control the food scald, if at all, if the animal is suffering with food scald. If the food scald is effectively controlled, there is no chance of getting the foot rot. This is an important point to be noted by the field veterinarians and all the participants. And not to purchase infected new sheep. If an infected new sheep is introduced which is suffering with foot rot, so it becomes a source of infection. So this is one way of preventing the infection into the flock, entry of infection into the flock. And always quarantine, this is a mandatory practice for whenever we bring new animals into the flock, not only to prevent the foot rot, this is quarantine is very much required, is part of farm management activity. And keeping shed dry and clean is another important part of preventing foot rot. And sprinkling lime powder on the floor, especially around water troughs. And not to keep sick and carrier with the healthy. And proper hoof trimming and timely hoof trimming. And among all the most important two points are not to purchase infected sheep and effectively controlling, if at all if they are suffering, effectively controlling the foot scald. Then if the animal is suffering with foot scald, which is a precursor of foot rot, how it should be controlled? See, if there is one individual case, if you find one or two cases, it can be treated using antibiotic aerosol sprays. And many of the flock are affected. If several are affected, better to use foot baths, 10% zinc sulfate solution or 3% formal is ineffective. And after foot bathing, sheep must stand in dry area. So again, we should make the foot dry. So after foot bathing, you keep all the animals in a dry area. And repeat the foot bathing weekly or once in 15 days. So no foot dripping is necessary for interstitial dermatitis. This is very, very important. Because hard area is not affected in the foot scald. In foot scald, only the interdistal area which is soft, that is only affected. So don't go for hoof trimming. So if you try to do hoof trimming, it may cause trauma and trauma will lead to the infection of foot rot. So foot scald is very easy to control. If you find individual cases, just by using antibiotic aerosol sprays, it can be controlled. And if many are suffering, use foot baths. And there is another line of defense. So whenever you bring new entries into the flock, so treat all new entries with long-acting antibiotics. See, instead of keeping in quarantine period, it is always better to keep all the new entries in quarantine period. But this is another line of defense, but it depends on the discretion of the local veterinarian. And the sanitation is very, very important to prevent this disease. Cleanliness of shed and cleanliness of equipment, because F. necrophorum is very much available in manure and shed and equipment also. So dry and clean floors, disinfection, this is very, very important part. Sanitation and hygiene is one of the important parameter of better farm management. So by following good sanitation and hygiene, we can prevent foot scald and foot rot also. So what about the vaccine? So in India, vaccine is not available. It is available in other countries, but in India, there is no vaccine for foot rot. But here is one good news. In December 2020, exactly 10 months back, Sri Venkateshwara Veterinary University of Tirupati of Andhra Pradesh, they have entered into one memorandum of understanding with Indian Immunological Limited towards transfer of technology for production of trivalent vaccine. See, there are 8 strains in foot rot causing bacteria, but SVVU have entered into an MOU with IAM to prepare a vaccine of trivalent potency. So probably it may be available in another 1 year. Then how to eradicate it? So it is totally possible. It is 100% possible to eradicate foot rot with best management practices. as there is no vaccine available for this, so best management practices is the only option left with the shepherds to eradicate it from the entire flock. But it requires a dedicated and disciplined approach. The dedicated and disciplined approach should be towards isolation of the affected, and soaking, that is foot baths, and trimming. So by following these three approaches, so this can be completely eradicated. So what are the reasons for high risk of foot scald in goats? So foot scald is seen mostly in goats, foot rot is seen mostly in sheep. So what are the reasons for this high risk of foot scald in goats? In goat, the distance between the tips is greater than sheep. See, you can see these two pictures. The foot sole is kidney shaped in goats. So this is the kidney shaped sole. This is the goat sole, goat foot sole. But this is the sheep sole. So goats keep on searching for browsing. So there is every chance of getting injury in between the interdigital area. As this is more open in case of goat. So whenever they go out for grazing, because we know very well that goat is a browser and sheep is a grazer. So goat always tries to pick leaves from different plants. So they keep on walking in search of food. So while walking, so there is every chance of getting injury in between the interdigital area because of the wide gap between these two toes. Because of wide gap between the two tips. But there is one important point. See, there is no chance of accumulation of mud in case of goat, because they are the more clean animals. So even if they suffer with foot scald, they don't suffer with foot rot because of this condition where goats are known as clean animals. And the chances of accumulation of mud between interdigital spaces is very less. There may be an injury. Because of injury or trauma, they suffer with foot scald. But because of non-accumulation of mud, so they didn't suffer with foot rot. So this is the sole of sheep. So you can see this is rectangular in shape. Sole of goat, this is kidney shape. So differential diagnosis of foot scald and foot rot. See, whenever we visit a flock to identify whether it is a foot scald or foot rot, so only point you can differentiate these two is, please check the interdigital area. If the interdigital skin area is affected, it is foot scald, and if the hoof is also affected, you see the picture, then this is foot rot. The interdigital skin and hoof, both are affected in foot rot, whereas in foot scald, only the interdigital skin area is affected. The predisposing factor for foot scald is irritation or a trauma, I told in the beginning slides. But for foot rot, foot scald is the precursor. Foot scald is the predisposing for foot rot, and this is seen in goat, and this is seen more in sheep. I repeat it again, in foot scald, the interdigital skin area is affected, whereas in foot rot, interdigital skin and hoof is affected. See, there are many other conditions which causes lamination in sheep and goat. So there are non-infectious reasons. One is tender sole, and there may be sharp object pricks like nails or thorns, and maybe because of injury and an interdigital trauma and overgrown hooves. These are the non-infectious causes which may lead to lameness in sheep and goat. But there are certain infectious reasons also which causes lameness, like FMD, bloaten, foot scald, foot abscess, and inflammation of interdigital pouch. See, there is one interdistal pouch. So if it is inflamed, the animal may suffer with lameness. But how to differentiate these conditions where we find lameness? So in all non-infectious reasons, the cases are sporadic and the spread pattern is also, it is very slow. It is, we don't call it as spread pattern, but the incidence of appearance of lameness is very slow. So let us check the non-infectious causes once again. Tender sole, sharp object pricks, injury, interdistal trauma, overgrown hooves. These are the non-infectious reasons, but these are sporadic cases. Whereas in infectious cases, disease-specific symptoms can be observed. So in FMD, you will find high fever, you will find abortions, and you will find other disease-specific symptoms also. Whereas in blue tongue also, you will find other specific symptoms. Foot scald, I have already explained how to differentiate it foot rot. So there is another condition called foot abscess. So abscess can be easily differentiated from foot scald and foot rot. And the last infectious cause is inflammation of interdistal pouch. So I will explain what is this interdistal pouch, because there is no need to explain about FMD and blue tongue, because all the participants are veterinarians, you know very well. So among infectious lameness conditions, inflammation of IDP is of much concern, particularly in rainy season. So this is the area where you will find interdistal pouch. So whenever you visit a sheep flock, you please look at this particular area. So this is the cross section. So this will be like this, like V-shaped one. So here is one X-ray photograph. You can find the interdistal pouch here. IDP, it is called as IDP. And it is in fact a sebaceous gland, an eyelid gland found between the phalanges in all limbs of the sheep. And a thick oily translucent secretion is discharged to the skin surface through a duct in the skin. Just I will show you this picture again. So here is the duct. From this point, some oily secretion is secreted into the skin. So this is the opening of the duct, opening of the pouch. And it plays an important role in sexual communication. And interdistal cystitis frequently occurs due to microorganisms and foreign bodies entering in the glot, causes lameness. So lameness is not always due to foot rot or foot scald. It may be due to infection of interdistal pouch also. But this interdistal pouch is rudimentary in goats. This is seen only in sheep. Please note this point. IDP is rudimentary in goats. So finally, before concluding my PowerPoint presentation, foot rot is a costly disease because there will be loss of productivity because of lameness, animal may not be able to walk for grazing. And even if it walks, it will be in the last of the entire flock. So it may not get sufficient food. If the nutrition is not proper, it always suffers with low productivity. So farmer may lose his income because of loss of productivity of sheep and goat. The treatment cost is too high. See, we need to use a broad spectrum antibiotics for a period of 7 days. Even after treatment, if it is not fully controlled, if it is not cured, we have to cull the animal. Otherwise, it becomes a source of infection and spread the infection within the flock. So culling should be done for low prices only. So there will be loss of breeding stock. So because of all these reasons, foot rot is considered as a costly disease. So prevention is always better than cure because there is no vaccine available for this. And foot scald is the precursor for foot rot. I am repeating it again. Foot scald is the precursor of foot rot. And if there is no interdistal trauma or irritation, there is no chance of foot scald. If there is no interdistal trauma or interdistal irritation, there is no chance of foot scab. And if there is no foot scab, there is no chance for foot rub. This is very important for the field veterinarians to understand, and also farmers also. So prevent interdistal trauma or irritation and prevent foot scab. And if we can prevent foot scab, there is no foot rub. Thank you all.